My blissful Gorgio friends, let us enter into the stanzas we left yesterday. So the gopis assemble together in Vrindavan and they are speaking to each other. Oh, my dear friends, the gopis said, oh dear me, look, what a wonder. That shining reflections of his laughter on his ear necklace, and beside that the dazzle of golden streak, that lasting flash of lightning, haravadhasyam yat harahasam, that's it, showering his mercy, bringing the light to the people who are dying, suffering. That's what happens when he sounds his flute. Then looking up at his friend, he smiles, and the friend laughs. Then Krishna laughs. Then the shine of his pearlish teeth flashes out. Shine of his reddish lips flashes out, and that reflects on conch, that reflects on each of the beads of his diamond necklaces, as if long garland of laughter. Exactly, that's how it appears. Haravadhasyam yasya. Oh, just look at that. Laughter upon laughter upon laughter is pearl upon pearl in his necklace.
Hanta chitram avalasrinutedam harasavra sisthiravidyo nandasu जनानां नर्मदो यरि पूजित वेणु वृंदशो वृज वृषामृग गावो वेणुवाद्य हृत चेतसयानां दंतदष्ट कवलादृत कर्णा निद्रिता
Another gopi said, no friend, not like that. Haravad vishado hasya yasyatam, like gorgeous necklace whose laughter is, whose laughter is like gorgeous necklace. That's him. He is Sri Krishna Bhagavan. No friend, not like that, another gopi said. Hasya eva vishadas purtim yas urasitam. Whenever he laughs, his laughter make an amazing big necklace. He is my Krishna Bhagavan. Friend, what do you mean? Does he not laugh in just a single piece? Does he laugh in continuum? Does he laugh eternity laughter? Oh, of course, yes, indeed, he laughs. And whenever and whomsoever it is addressed to experiences his or her whole life is filled with joys of laughter. Even the life itself becomes a perpetual laughter. In fact, a cosmic laughter is life becomes. Garland after garlands, necklace after necklaces of thrills and bliss of laughter are flung into his or her life, my dear friends. And you know what? It's endless.
Hanta chitram avalasrinutedam.
Oh dear me, O dear friend, how hopeless are we about all the powerless ladies. Being a woman means a powerless entity, and Upanishad says, Nayam Atma Valahinena Labhya. The self, the absolute reality cannot be attained by powerless creatures destined to vegetable life. A pressure, a force, a push is needed for water in the pipe to ascend to the seventh story of the building. So also to rise above kids and wife and hubby and wealth and prestige, a force is required which solves all the problems. In order to move on the path of God or the absolute reality or samadhi or enlightenment, let problems be right there where they are. Don't touch them. Just turn inside and run down. Embrace God Almighty so grindingly, so crushingly, so intimately, so much. So that, to do that, some power is needed. The power of sankalpa, the power is power of love united with sankalpa. So then you are sabal. Not all the muscular people, all those who are working in gyms and doing so much exercise or doing yoga, they are not powerful. That is not the way of being powerful. Here he or she alone is powerful who has willpower, whose willpower is entwined with a tremendous love, neck deep love and willpower to do anything in the world. So much power is needed to attain enlightenment. When the gopis have that power, whenever anyone gets that point of meaning, it turns out to be a Vasudeva. Vasudeva eva balam yasam ta avala. You become all powerful since Krishna becomes your power. Upanishad says, who has no face is laughing. Who has no shoulder is wearing necklaces. One who is absolute emptiness is absolutely a fullness and has fallen in love with the gopis of Vrindavan hopelessly. Helplessly he has fallen in love. What a wonder! And one who has no mouth is blowing air in his flute. One who is beyond breath is breathing into the flute. And a great music is resounding. Then, my dear friends, look what's happening. Filled with immense delight, deers and does, cows and bulls have come running from far away. Peacocks have descended, and even lions and cubs and their families have come to see our Krishna. They are heart captivated. They are standing around him with erect ears, entranced as though they are painted artworks. Half-chewed grass hangs from their mouth. Sri Krishna's flute music is a great donor of samadhi indeed, my dear friends. Sri Krishna's presence in his music is donor of, infuser of, transmitter of huge mystic trances of all kinds. Shukdevji Maharaj continues,
वरिणास्तबकधातु पलाशै बद्धमल्लपरिबर्हविडम्बा करिचि सबलयालिसगोपै गासमावयति यत्र मुकुन्दः. The gopi says, dear friends, look, ever since our Krishna has begun eliminating Vrindavan, he hasn't used a single item imported from Vaikunth. Okay? Look at his waving peacock with the crown on his head. Do you know why he wears that? Because the eyes painted on it resembles our eyes. It reminds him of us. Sri Radha has a lovely peacock. As soon as he hears flute music, he dances filled with love. A feather slips off. Krishna picks it up and tucks it in his crown. Why is he so much attached to peacock feather, my friend? Because peacock loves cloud. Sweet blue dark cloud. Its sweet rumble combines with the flute sound. That's why, friend, that's why. And you know what? He decorates his crown with multiple tufts of peacock feathers and tender leaves. That means each for each one of us. Wow! Is that so? Gopis are blissed out to think of that. Which one for me? Which one for me? Look how magnificently he is painted with minerals of various colors and putting on garb of a wrestler. He is playing his flute, calling cows gone too far. As he stands on the bank of Yamuna River beside Balaram, all his friends also surround him and calling cows to come and drink water. Then what? What happens? Tarri bhagnagataya sarito vai tatpadam bujarajo nilanita priyayati My dear friends, in Sanskrit language, a river is called Sarita. Sarita means Sarati Abhisarati Iti Sarita, whose water is constantly flowing non-stop. Or Nadanti Iti Nadyaha, the one which shouts aloud hara 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 hara, or shouts aloud hari 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 hari. That's Nadi, the river. So just like a speedily rushing lover, speedily rushing lover, the rivers are flowing towards the ocean. There is Manasi Ganga river in Brajmandal. There is Saraswati river, and there is Yamuna river, and there are 68 small and big rivulets, and they have been flowing fast to reach the ocean. But look, as soon as flute music resounded, their egoless, timeless, stationless flow stops. Goddess of the river lips her benign face and looks at the amazing sight on her shore. She is filled with instant blossom of all her lotuses and lilies. She gazes lovingly to the flute playing sapphirish illumination. Our Krishna, all plants, birds and wildlife, including nature, are motionless. She feels, "Oh Shyama Sundar, how great and wonderful you are. Oh, I am not worthy to meet you, dear. So restless and fickle-minded I have been all along with no peace. How can I have your ambrosial embrace, oh Lord? Oh, all I am worthy for is Tat Padam Bhujarajo Nilanita. All I am worthy for is I yearn just for a dust of your holy feet. Oh dear breeze, do me a favor, carry up some particle of dust from his lotus feet, and I will be blessed. That will be enough. My great, great good fortune, that's all I can expect." And through arms of her waves, she lifts up a flower and strikes her shore, trying to offer him a love tribute. "Oh dear breeze, I beg you, I will give you anything you want, just to get me some dust from his feet. I'll paste it as ointment in my eyes, smear it on my forehead like sandal paste. I'll eat it as medicine for my lovesick heart. Bring me a little holy dust from up there, Tat Padam Bhujarajo Nilanitam. Tat Padam Bhujarajo Nilanitam. But in order to have a dust of lotus feet of Sri Krishna, a great love, a great service, big IQ level is required, which alone you will be able to dump all your billion-dollar home and trillion-dollar projects and plans and dreams into Atlantic Ocean, my dear. Big, gigantic, sky-high, meritorious or big accumulation of several trillion noble deeds are needed. The gopis say rivers are too poor in that. The whole world is a pauper. Why? Because Tadburi Bhagyamiha Janmatimapyatavyam Yan Gokule Pikatamam Rirajo Vishekam. Even Brahmaji says, "I am the offender of gopas and gopis and holy cows and Sri Krishna. I cannot afford to ask for Krishna's. Even the dust of gopis' feet would be very great for me." So says Brahmaji. The river picks up a lotus with hands of her waves and lo, rises to the shore where Sri Krishna is standing. But alas, their hands tremble and their tribute falls down in the water. In a great despair, they are stilled as if waiting for the most fortunate holy cows to come and drink from them, whom Sri Krishna himself is calling through his flute music. अनुचरै समनुवर्णित वीर्यम्।